Welcome to the next lecture of Mechanics of Material. So we were discussing about the cantilever beams, and in last lecture we have seen a problem on cantilever beam with point loads. In this we are going to discuss a cantilever beam with a UDL load. So UDL load, they will be giving the load as 2 kilo. Here it has given as 1 kilonewton per meter. So the unit of UDL will always be given in terms of Newton per meter. So this meter itself will indicate that. So the value is given per meter. So you have to multiply with the length to which it has been applied to obtain the total weight of this or total force of this load. For example, here they have given 1 kilonewton per meter, then you have to multiply with 1.5, then only you will get the total load because of this UDL. Okay, so let us try to solve this problem. Okay, so they have clearly mentioned in the problem, cantilever beam of load of length 2 meters carries a UDL of 1 kilonewton per meter over 1.5 meter length from free end. Free end is this one. So from free end I have drawn the diagram. So when we drawn the diagram, so keep this entire page is left out for your shear force and bending moment calculation. Okay, so let us do like this. So I am giving the namings to the points. So this is my A point, this is my B point, this is my C point, this is my A, B, C. Okay, so obtain C. Once you have done this, you have to understand that where the beam is fixed at that point, you will be having a vertical reaction as well as the horizontal reaction. Vertical reaction as well as horizontal reaction. Okay, once you do this, you go for sign convention. Okay, sign convention, you need not to do the whole procedure which you have done in the previous lecture. You just have to write right to left. We are solving the problem from right to left. It is not compulsory that you always solve from right to left. Sometimes we even prefer to solve from left to right, basing upon the type of load. Okay, so most of the time we solve it from right to left. Okay, so when we say right to left, downward force we have known. Downward force is equal to positive. Next is CCW moment, counterclockwise moment, is equal to positive. So these two I know. Downward force is equal to positive, upward counterclockwise. You write this in a corner so that it will keep a reminder for you to how to solve this type of problems. Now I am trying to solve shear force calculation. Before going to shear force calculation, let us identify what is the value of your RA. For identifying that, what you have to do is you have to take bending, I have written a first statement, beam is under equilibrium. Beam is under equilibrium. So if beam is under equilibrium, upward forces is equal to downward forces. Upward forces is equal to downward forces. So what is upward force here we are having is only RA. Okay, so that I am taking it as RA. Okay, so what is upward force we are having here? RA. So I will write it as RA is equal to downward force. We are having only one downward force, that is because of UDL. How to identify the force because of this UDL is nothing but you have to write the value of UDL 1 into what is the length to which UDL has been spanned. So it is present for a length of 1.5. So I will write 1.5. So we will get the load of this value. So RA is equal to 1.5 kilonewton. You have to write RA is equal to 1.5 kilonewton. Okay. So once you are done the solving, you give the value of RA here directly. RA is equal to 1.5 kilonewton. So equilibrium already you have discussed. First thing is summation of horizontal forces 0. Next is summation of vertical forces 0. Next is summation of moment is equal to 0. So this upward forces is equal to downward forces is because of summation of vertical forces is equal to 0. Next we are having summation of horizontal forces is equal to 0. So horizontal forces, we have only one horizontal force, that is horizontal reaction at point A, that we will write implies HA is equal to 0. HA is equal to 0. So other than this we don't have any horizontal force, so it is becoming directly 0. No need in cantilevers, no need to identify the moment calculation, no need to identify, go for moment calculation. Okay, next is where we go for shear force calculation. What is that? Shear force calculation, SF calculation we write, or shear force, whatever you want to write. So generally I will split this, one side we will do bending moment, one side we will do shear force, one side we will do bending moment, one side we will do shear force. Okay, so let us do shear force calculation. So for drawing the shear force calculation, you should remember the points. So keep the diagram on the left side and try to solve it. So first point which you are having is shear force before the rightest corner. So if you see the diagram, I will redraw the diagram here at the top corner. So right, we are having a cantilever with UDL, okay, UDL, which is having a corner B and C. One rightest corner is C and one corner is B, and this is your point A. Okay, for my identification purpose, what points I have to take? So I have drawn this diagram. Okay, shear force before C. Before C, we don't have any load, so this is 0. Next is shear force at C. So at C means exactly at point C, exactly at point C also, we don't have any kind of load. If you go this, okay, at point C also you don't have any load. So I even you can see that we are having a UDL. So for UDL, what we have told, UDL into length. So point UDL and the length of the load at point C is almost equal to 0. Okay, so we will consider this 1.1 into 0, that is nothing but 0. 1 into 0 is nothing but 0. Okay, when we say shear force at point C, you have to see the loads which are right side to it. We are having no load, so shear force is equal to 0. Next, shear force at point C is equal to, at point C is also we are having only load, but there is no distance. So 1 into 0, it is 0. But whereas shear force at before B is nothing but, we are having entire UDL, that is 1 into 1.5, that is 1.5 kilonewton. Next is shear force at point B. At point B we are having, at point B we are having no point load, we are having only load because of UDL right side to it. So again at point B also we'll get the same value as this. Next is shear force at point A also, before point A also we are having no extra loads, we are having the same load, that is 1 into 1.5, will get the same value. But when you come to point A, when you come to point A, there will be an extra point load. When you come to point A, there will be an extra point load, that is vertical reaction at point A, that is why, which is acting in upward direction, and its value is 1.5. So 1.5 minus 1.5, this is because of the load which is before A, and this is because of the load which is exactly at point A. So you are getting the value as 0. Once you get this answer, go for the shear force diagram. So in this you have to mark the points. So first is 0 point, next is 1.5, next is 1.5, next is 0. So once you mark the points, just join the points by using a inclined line and a straight line. So this is entire positive shear force diagram. So you have to mark this distance as 1.5 kilonewton. So since this is positive, we will write it as positive. We have already discussed this is a baseline. What is a baseline or zero line is nothing but the where the shear force will remain zero on entire length. So once we are done with this, we will go for bending moment calculation. I am doing bending moment calculation very next to the shear force calculation itself. Okay, let us keep this diagram as it is. Bending moment calculation, we are solving from right to left. We have to see the right corner point. Bending moment at point C is equal to 0. Next is bending moment at point B is equal to, at point B we are having the load right side to it, because of which the moment may be created. This UDL is acting in downward direction. It try to rotates in anti-clockwise direction. First of all, we have to identify what is the load because of this. That is 1 into 1.5 into CG of it. What does this CG is nothing but half of the distance of the UDL. So the UDL is present for a length of 1.5. So from this corner to this distance is 1.5 divided by 2. So 1.5 divided by 2. So the value of that you are getting as minus 1.125 kN per meter. Now let us calculate the bending moment about point A. So this is your point A. Your CG is present here now. Your CG is present here now. Now you have to measure the distance, this entire distance. What is this entire distance? This is already 1.5 divided by 2 plus this value is 0.5. So first of all, let us take the load minus 1 into 1.5. This is because of force. Next, the CG value or the distance of the CG from that point is nothing but 0.5 plus 1.5 divided by 2. 0.5 plus 1. Why this 0.5? This distance, okay, this distance plus 1.5 2 is nothing but the CG of that value. So you measure this value, that is 0.5 plus of 1.5 divided by 2. 1.5 divided by 2, you will get as 1.25 plus into this value 1 into 1.5. So you are getting this value as minus 1.875 kilo Newton meter. Minus, you can see the value, minus 1.875 kilo Newton meter. Once you got this values, go to your bending moment or shear for the place where you have left for bending moment diagram. Go there, draw the line, baseline. Okay, so since this is a negative half, we are getting here all the values are negative. No need to draw that. If you are getting positive and negative, try to leave some gap, okay. If it is having only negative, means you can write exactly just below the value. Now see the values what we are having here. First value is 0, next value is 1 minus 1.125, that next value is minus 1.875, okay. First value is 0, I have marked it. Next value is minus 1.125 kilo Newton meter. Next value we are going to get it as minus 1.875 kilo Newton meter. Then how to join these two? Since they are here, UDL is present, the bending moment diagram, you will get it as a parabolic curve. How to remember this? Where we have to draw the parabolic curve is nothing but if your shear force is having an inclined line. You can write here, this is inclined straight line, inclined straight line, okay. If your diagram is having inclined, shear force diagram is having inclined straight line, then your bending moment diagram will get a parabolic curve. So you write it here, parabolic curve. Once you get this parabolic curve, you have to write here. Next, see here, what is the type of line you are getting? If you are getting a normal straight line, then in bending moment diagram you will get a inclined straight line. Okay, so what is this maximum value you have to indicate here? The value you are getting is 1.875 kilo Newton meter. So which side you are getting? All the values are negative here. I will write the diagram as negative. So this is your bending moment diagram.